Well, hello again, Hadley. Well, it's great to see you again, and it's great to be here again. It is, that's right. Now, Hadley, you were thinking about something over the half-term holiday, weren't you?
Yeah, I was.
Yeah, would you want to tell us what it was?
Well, you know, last half-term,
yeah,
we were talking about all the miracles Jesus did.
Well, do you know, Hadley, we didn't talk about all the miracles Jesus did, because in the Bible, in the book that John wrote...
Oh, yeah, what's that called again?
It's called John.
All right.
Yeah, in that book, John said that if everything was written down that Jesus did, all the miracles and all the things he did, there wouldn't be enough books in the world to contain them.
Wow, that would take ages to tell everyone about.
It would, that's right. But that wasn't your question, was it?
No, I wondered.
Yeah?
Well, are there any miracles anywhere else in the Bible?
Do you know, that's a really good question, Hadley.
I thought it was, yeah.
And, you know, I think it will be a really good idea to think about some of the other miracles in the Bible. Some miracles that other people did.
Oh, that's great. Were they all just like Jesus then?
No, they weren't. But most of them were prophets. Those were people that God used to tell lots of people about him and all the amazing things he did.
All right.
So God gave them the special ability to do special miracles as well, to show people how much God cared about them and how much he loved them.
All right, go on then, tell us one.
Okay, well, the first one I want to tell you about is all to do with a very poor lady.
Oh dear, why was she so poor?
Well, do you know, this lady was married, but unfortunately, her husband died.
Right, okay, so what did she do then?
Well, the problem was, Hadley, that there was nobody to look after her, because in those days, they didn't get a benefit or extra money from the government if their husband died.
Oh, I see.
So she was very, very worried. And she had two sons as well, so it was really expensive to keep them all fed and happy and comfortable.
Oh, okay.
So she went to see somebody called Elisha. Elisha was a prophet.
Right, okay, I'm with you so far.
Okay. And she said, I don't know what to do. My husband's died and I owe some money, and the people that I owe the money to are going to come and take my sons away to be slaves.
Oh no, I've never heard anything like that before.
No,
don't do that to me, will you?
Of course I won't do it to you, Hadley. But it was a really desperate situation.
Well, there's no answer to that, is there?
Well, that's what she thought. But she went to see Elisha because she knew he was a man of God, and God may well have an answer for her.
All right, so what did Elisha do then? Did he make a magic pot of money appear?
No, he didn't do that, Hadley.
Did he show her where she could find some money, you know, dig up some treasure?
No, he didn't even do that. He said something very strange to her. You see, he wanted her to show how much she trusted God.
Right.
So he said to her, well, look, what have you got in the house?
Well, you just said she didn't have anything.
Well, she had just a little bit of oil, olive oil, in a jar.
Oh, right.
So Elisha said, look, I want you to go around to all your neighbours and all your friends in the town.
Right.
And ask them if you could borrow jars from them.
Right.
Get as many as you possibly can and bring them back to your house.
Okay, so did she do that?
She did, yeah. She and her sons went to all the neighbours' houses and got as many jars as they possibly could.
Right.
And then Elisha said, take your little jar of oil and start to fill those other jars.
She only had a little bit.
Yes, I know, but that was the amazing thing. You see, as she poured the oil into all the other jars, the oil didn't run out.
Really?
Yeah. And she kept asking her sons, go and bring me another jar, quickly.
And she kept pouring the oil into the jars.
Yeah, and it filled up the jars. It filled up jar after jar after jar.
Wow.
And nobody saw her because Elisha said, close the door. Don't let anybody watch. Except your two sons.
Wow. And eventually, she said to her son, go and get another jar. Right, did he just keep conning the jars?
No. This time, Hadley, do you know what happened?
No.
Well, the son came back and he said, but Mum, that was the last jar. We haven't got any more.
Oh, no.
Well, it's not bad news, Hadley, because what happened then was the jar that she had suddenly stopped making all this extra oil.
Oh, strange. It was, wasn't it?
So she went to see Elisha again and she said, look, I've filled up all the jars with extra oil from my one little jar. What shall I do now? And Elisha said,
can I guess?
Go on then.
Did he say take the oil back to all those people?
Well, a bit more than that actually, Hadley, because he said to her, go and sell the olive oil and that will be enough money to pay off all your debts.
Oh, fantastic.
Except that when she'd done that, she even had oil left over and that gave her money to live on, her and her son.
Oh, that's amazing. So, she believed that God could help her.
Yeah, that's right.
And so she did what he asked.
That's right.
And that gave her everything she needed to pay off her debts and to live comfortably with her two lads.
That's exactly right, Hadley. Isn't that an amazing story?
It is amazing.
So that's the first of the miracles that Jesus didn't do and somebody else did, but with God's help.
Oh, that's what you got to remember, isn't it?
It is. Two things, actually, that God wants to help us. And secondly, sometimes we just have to do what God asks us to do,
just like the lady did.
That's right. Okay, I tell you what, let's say a little prayer together and then we'll listen to a song.
Okay.
Dear Lord God, we thank you that you looked after that lady that was in so much trouble, and we thank you that she believed that you could help her. It was an amazing story, so help us to remember that we need to trust in you and do as you ask us to do, and then you'll look after us in really special ways. Amen.
Amen.
Good boy, Hadley. Okay, here's a song for you, and we'll see you all later. Bye.
Bye.
Come here.